All right, there we are. Welcome to the motherfucking Rick Show. That's a little bit louder than I wanted to be in my ears, but that's all right. It does tend to run on the loud side. Okay. Alright, so this is this is Shadowrun Hong Kong, the extended edition, which has a bunch of other crap on it too. Bunch of stories, just a bunch of isometric old school kind of tactical gaming. Man, it's still kinda loud in my ears, but it's all good. I think I'll be fine. I'm not gonna start screaming or anything like that. I'd like to see if I could clear chat, but I guess you can't really. It's all good, actually. It's pretty quick to close and oh shit. That's alright. I'm freaking out and I got a button right here to launch it again. But not a problem. That's not what I wanted. Yeah, it sucks that every time you try to copy the game source, it goes to shit. Alright, so let's do a new game. Let's load a game. The music is really getting on me. Yeah, that's better. That's way better. Holy shit. He's like, on your ass. Yeah, so I have everything's turned out the way I wanted to. Everything's good. This is actually a pretty easy game on your system. So if you have... I don't want to look at it. I want to do a new game. If you have a system, an older system, I mean, I'm not talking about, like, ancient. What's Shadows of Hong Kong extra bonus? You need to import a final save. The final save game for the main campaign. Let's see. Yeah, I got quite a few different ones that I subscribe to. I think this one is. The cycle concludes with Cal Free. Okay, after Cal the Cut. The cycle was the Calfrain chains. So this is the one before the one I'm playing right now. I think I'm gonna do it. Let me see what else is there. Enemy of my enemy. This is the guy that did two of them. So he's got specific music for Calfrain. But I like the music anyways, no matter. So I think I'd rather use it for both of them and then use the Hong Kong music for Hong Kong. But this is the music from I think. Dragon, what's it called? Dragon, I forget what it's called. Dragon something or other. But we'll get started here in a moment. I need to pick, I'm gonna play him backwards because I've been playing this one for a little bit now. This one's good, I enjoy it. It's a lot of fighting, that one. Lego concludes with count. Yeah, so I'm, no, no. Yeah, okay, count the cotton, we'll do it. I have more stories, I think it's gonna take me to Steam Overlay. There's not that many good stories, so. And I think, I should really read this. You can always change the difficulty. Let me see, the overlay is gonna pop. Let me bring up this Dead Man's Switch, is also good, from what I heard. Okay, this guy. What's his freaking name? time. He's got two of them anyways. But this is not the one, this is not what I was looking for. I mean, look at his workshop. Yeah, he's got this one. Okay, there we go. Cavalcade Caper. And this one, let me see what he says about it. Okay, this is not worry about the story. Story driven gameplay, your character's personal tale. Recruit a small core. Okay, let me, no, that's fine. Get about to go to Sai and enjoy the return of Cal Free. The minute is complete, running smoothly in the most players. Okay, so it doesn't give you a finally enjoy. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna play it normal difficulty, but the other one was really difficult, so I couldn't play it in normal difficulty. Oops. Yeah, playing normal. If it gets too hard, I'll turn it down. This is actually more story driven than anything else, but the combat is still fun. I don't think I've played one dude yet in this game. I don't know why. But I've been pretty much playing the same character every time. And it's a dwarf. And it's not male. And it's always an adept. Although I really should just go for none and just kind of pick and choose what I want. And I tend to pick the same similar path every time. You know, I kind of know the game is not that complex. It is in some ways, very deep in some ways, but not so much in others. Yeah, the customization is a little on the limited side. You know, I got my girls I like. They're a big, frizzy, pompadourish, freaking... that's crazy right there. Alright. Yeah, she's probably my favorite dwarf, because she doesn't really look like one. And these are like, what? So I must have picked up some portraits without knowing it. That's one thing I should look for, is portraits, but... I don't think there are any. You know what? I don't even know. Community hub. Let's go to the... Although I don't know if I'll be able to use them right away. Fortress is 14. Let's check them out. Hold on, it gave me... I said portraits. Gave me a bunch of that I already had. Companions, there's a lot of stuff I'm subscribed to. Gold play is what? Another campaign. Yeah, there really aren't any. This is a 14 portraits. It's tagged with this. I think these are all tagged with everything. What's this one? Eat props and portraits and test maps. A lot of props, each set component, test map reference grids. Okay, well, how can you use this one? You just write a 3D, which no UC can add. UC can add all the parts of the image that are lit with the same foxy light in the engine. Okay, let me see what it says here. Let's subscribe, although I doubt it's gonna work right away. I have to, some games require that you relaunch before the item will be downloaded. Yeah, I probably will have to relaunch. That's fine though. Still doing, okay. Let's see what Steam says. That was download. There we go. Why isn't it going now? Damn it. Nothing's ever easy, I tell ya. Initiated at 10:19 a.m. No, that's not. I want it to be now. Why can't they go now? It's ready to play, but initiate. Oh, fuck it. I tell you, man, nothing ever goes easy. Should have gotten something to drink. Oh, I got some. I got some here. New game. Cod the Cod Caper. Launch campaign. Normal confirm. Alright, this is gonna be pretty straightforward. Ah, shit, what the hell am I clicking over there? Yeah, sorry about that. I wasn't gonna like take any input on the looks of our friend, as it is anyway. So I killed the mic while I was doing that part, just in case somebody wanted to chime in and say, "Don't do that." Like, oh yeah, but shit. Karma represents the experience characters earn while running the shadows and achieving goals. Karma is used to improve attributes and skills. An attribute or skill rating can be increased by spending karma equal to the next increment in that rating. Thus, improving your body from 4 to 5 requires you to spend 5 karma points. You have some karma available now to customize your character. So at the beginning of the game, you always get some karma to kind of build your character out. This is an adept, which is a fighting sort of monk kind of character that can use melee weapons like Like a ninja? I guess he would be like, yeah, he'd be sort of ninja-ish, I guess, to a certain extent. But with less stealth and more punchy in the face. But he's not a samurai, which is a whole different thing. Two samurais are a whole different thing. And they're not strictly Japanese, although the term is Japanese. The Japanese term is used, I think, more as a kind of a nod to the origins of this this content, which comes from William Gibson's great contribution to literature in the form of cyberpunk. And he's always been called the father of cyberpunk, although I don't know if he actually thinks he is. But he didn't take too kindly to Shadowrun. He thought it was he didn't get it. And I could see that because he's not that kind of guy. He's kind of his subject matter is pretty serious. I mean, what he's talking about is he takes it pretty seriously. But I don't know, you have to be able to laugh at yourself and see what culture does with what you create and not get too stuck on it. So as an adept, my focus is, I think, body strength and wisdom. And as a troll, I get a pretty hefty boost to body and strength. So I can spend 5 here, which I wouldn't mind doing. Let's bring all of these to where they belong. Yeah. Wisdom's going to be a bit lower for him. At the most, I think I'm probably, since I'm not going to really use, although I should use melee weapons with him. Take the chance to hit with chi, casting attacks, casting, that's a lot of depths. Yeah, I mean, there are some abilities you can use, but Mystic Armor, I think, is the only one that's kind of worth going after, but that's a lot of points to spend on it. You can't get this far, so you'll never get this spell. So his whole thing's mainly going to be to be fat, or her whole thing. To be fast, to be able to punch. It'll be a mixture of, I'm not going to go too far here on the full willpower. This is as far as we're going. Might be some spell casting that I might be able to do. That's good. We're gonna just have 17 left still. Yeah, I don't know how far I'm gonna get, how many points I'm gonna get, so I want to make her as viable as possible. These stories may not last that long. I don't know how generous the author is gonna be as far as giving us points, but I'm definitely gonna spend some coins on combat here. That's good. And throwing weapons, right? Yeah, hand grenades, throwing weapons, definitely spending some points on that. Yeah, this is completely tied to each other. This is nice, I like that. In case I can't get to somebody. Yeah, body is just like hit points. Quickness is nice if you can afford to spend some points on it. Because it helps you dodge. But here I have 5 points that I want to live for, so that means I have 4 points I can spend if I want to. Let's see. I'm going to leave it like that. Big distraction does plus 1 AP damage, or this is HP damage by 3. The thrown weapons might be the way to go, I think. Just to like stop people in their tracks. slot. What I'd like to do is open this up, but I can't. Let's see again what's under quickness here. Let's do dodge and let's do that. Let's do strength and close combat, I think. I knew I was going to leave 1 point. I think we're good. Charisma is tempting. Because you'll learn an etiquette that you might be able to use, but an etiquette is, doesn't really explain etiquette. Well, actually, here, an etiquette's coming up. Matter of fact, you get one etiquette, because your charisma is one, get one at the beginning. Well, my charisma is one. You have unspent karma, you're sure you want to finish the character creation? Hold on, do I have 1 point I can spend somewhere? I guess spellcasting, I guess spell, but I don't want to, I could save that point and spend it somewhere I really want to. Instead of, if I have the spell power, willpower, biotech decking, conjunct control. Okay. That's worth it. Alright, so what are we doing here? She's a troll. But this is the name, this is not the name she's gonna be using a lot of. Ooh, I got it already. Get it already. That's right. Let's see. Star. Do I want to cut the... Nah, let's just do it as it is. Ooh, the silence that was that you know the game. Game saying, ooh, running the gauntlet. Some folks think Shadowrunners lead glamorous lives, yeah. Those who enter the shadows quickly learn otherwise. Being a runner means taking the jobs that come your way, no matter how dangerous, no matter how unpopular. Today starts the same as every day has for the last 3 miserable years, patrolling the Gauntlet, the most dangerous zone in the deadliest city in the Bay Area sprawl. The life of a runner cop is decidedly unglamorous and tends to be short as well. You lasted this long thanks to, in part, thanks in part to a highly developed sense of paranoia and thanks in part to Rafik Tooth. Who has walked at this beat even longer than you. Rafik Tooth, I wonder who that is. Has walked this beat longer than you. So I'm a runner cop. Wonderful. A runner cop in the world of Shadowrun is not that good. Okay. Music's pretty lively. Look at them. These are the uniforms they wear as runner cops. You okay there, sport? You look like you were a million miles away. And they're both trolls. Look at that. Call me sport. All good, Rafik. Don't worry about me. I was just thinking about what happened on our last patrol. I'd give anything to be a million miles away from this shithole. I'd say that one. Still not a fan of the gauntlet, eh? Can't say I blame you. Let's keep saving you, Nguyen. Maybe you can take a vacation up at Orbital one of these days. Well, the sooner we finish our rounds, the sooner we can get off the streets. I'm ready whenever you are. Special update this time. Do you think we can be... But in the game in general... Oh, I forgot that freaking dragon's going to be in the way a little bit. In the game in general, it's all sort of like this. This is the main gist of the game. Sort of like this three, and you can't see my mouse on the on the left hand side you'll have this sort of like where you're at kind of thing, and when you engage in conversation with someone you'll be able to sort of see them to a certain extent. They don't see the environment that you're in, so it's actually pretty well detailed. I mean, you see the benches back here, the little kiosk with the umbrella over it, that, you know, bulletin board, what do you want to call it. There's even like a little truck, a food truck with an umbrella on the top that has a motorcycle attached, but nobody's actually there, so maybe it's closed for the night. Or maybe it's just abandoned. Benches, ATMs, phones. Although, why would they even have a phone? The future, baby. And then, you know, smoke effects. Well, the sooner we finish our round, so he tells, okay, so I'm like, hey, do you think there'll be any blowback from the last shooting? From the court? Nah. When's the last time they gave two shits about some poor sinless truck gunned down the street? You just need to remember to fill out that requisition for armor reimbursement. From the streets, though, yeah, maybe. He was packing, but his back was turned. That always looks bad. No matter what the exterior circumstances, if he had any friends, they'll probably make an appearance. Any special objectives for tonight? Just the usual, make ourselves visible, try to goad anyone who wants to take a pot shots at the Shiwanese Express to shoot at us instead, then we shoot them, rinse and repeat. You think that the gangsters would have learned by now to hold their fire. Our Kretziks should be grateful that they haven't. And I'm like, yeah, let's go. So pretty soon we're gonna probably have to fight something. Maybe keeping the music wasn't such a good idea, because it's a little on the lively side. Oh, that's as far as you go. What is this place? Oh, it's like in some sort of... It's like Taiwanese. The graffiti is really cool, to be honest. I don't know, on your screen you can't really get that close, but... Yeah, my screen, the graffiti is really nice, and there's like some burning garbage over here. Let me look in here. Alright. Yeah, I wanted to bring the cursor into it because that way I can point out a lot of like cool stuff that the game has for such a small kind of like indie kind of game. Of course, there's some like shit dribbling out of this van right here. The models are not too bad. The sprites are not too bad. They're 3D. They look alright. Here's a bunch of garbage burning inside of a building. Electrical sparks coming off some sort of unit, air conditioning unit, or maybe it looks like a biohazard unit of some kind. So you can talk to people if they have a little, oh, what the hell is that? Well, that's just trash. Sometimes trash will just manifest. This is a totem, and if you have magical abilities, you may be able to bring some sort of, spirit out of it to help you defeat your enemies. God damn, my music is really... So there's people around, as you can see right over here, but there's nothing above their heads. Oh, hold up here. I should check this out. Alone. Alone? You've known for some time that Rafiq makes extra prayers on the side. Nothing too obvious, but he has a habit of brief absences and hushed conversations in the middle of your route. So do I nod? We have to stay together. I'd like the taste of whatever you're getting. And I'm like, oh yeah, let me as well. Hey, well, I can't say you haven't earned it. A lot of women would have turned me in for an easy payday long before now. Just as every time before, Rafiq disappears into the alley for a few moments to continue to survey the street. Oh, who the hell is this? You spot a small figure disappearing beneath a manhole cover as Rafiq walks back towards you. A dwarf then. Unless Oakland has a gang of subterranean street urchins, you wouldn't be surprised. Now, shall we? This Cora know about? The fuck is Cora? What's that about? A little bit of information arbitrage. Nothing that the dwarves wouldn't be able to figure out on their own once Friday rolled around. It's valuable for them to know during a few days in advance, though. They are happy to pay for the convenience. Just giving some early info. Let's keep moving instead of just staying in the same spot for too long around here. And also because we need to get into a fight. Ooh, Nuyen. Give me that Nuyen. Yeah, you see, nobody's got the little tags above their head. Ooh, take care, Black Star. Looks like trouble up ahead. Eavesdrop on the gangsters. So yeah, usually there's these tags right here that I'll let you know when something important is happening. Again, this is a custom adventure, so the paper just suddenly like blows up out of nowhere. I don't know if there's something here, but we can sneak up on the gangsters. Gang are heavy. Ready to do this thing? Gang are stupid.
Hell yeah! Zero will be stoked that we finally took him down.
Gang are heavy. Wait, is he on the horn? The gangers come that crackles alive. A fervent voice bellows out. Its force evident, even though it's a tiny speaker.
Today, you struck a great blow for the better human people's army against those who seek to keep us down. Our enemies will learn not to intrude on our turf.
And then he said,
never wait the fools.
God damn, that killed my throat. Oh my god. And the ambient sounds of the woman screaming.
Fuck the man. Fuck Saito. And fuck everyone associated with this goddamn rail line. Now get out there and do your thing.
Ugh. Oh, look, there's a new chief in the MPA. You better break up whatever they're planning or they'll be held to pay a shy ways. Holy shit. Ugh. Okay, so we're getting into a fight early. This looks like a real, like, kind of a cakewalk. I'm gonna kill the dragon if you guys don't mind. Well, not literally kill him. He'll be fine. Ooh. Oh, can I close this now? Okay. Let's see what happens. Oh, okay, so they're gonna take cover now. Oh no, did he take off running? How am I gonna get in there?
Hi, flunkies!
Mataface? Mataface. Who's this one back here?
Mataface, I'm Mataface your ass.
Well, we're going to... Yeah, put some killing hands on. What is he? What can he do? He is... Oh. What is he? Oh, by the way, if you press escape, you get the PDA here. You can take a look at your team and see what they're all about. He's a shaman. Yeah, that makes sense. He's got a real cool, like, troll name, and I give my girl, like, a Latina name. Maybe she's a half-troll, you know? She's been banging some humans. You never know. She's like, you know, third generation human troll, de-splicing there going on. Yeah, I gotta get something to drink because I am choking. My voice. My attempt to give him that voice. I'll be right back. I'm back. Okay. Alright, so yeah, he's a shaman. So that'll be pretty useful. They're pretty good for support. So she's gonna be the bullet sponge. The tank, more or less. Played Adepts a lot. I've only finished the game with a rigger. I play Adepts on these little missions. Okay. Good, she's ready to rock. Let's knock the guy out. He needs cover. Anything else? No, everything is still cover. There's not really any really good cover. He's got great cover. He's got a heavy cover. Let's move him right here. Oh, goddamn, he's got a shotgun. Oh yeah, he's a bear totem. He's a bear, shaman. Heals allies, what? And then three tiles. That's not three tiles. Well, let's just keep on working on this guy since he needs to get worked on a little bit. Let's punch him again. Nice, he's dead. Anywhere to take, there's no good cover on here, is there? She's in good cover, she's in heavy cover. But I don't know. Yeah, and I don't know if moving him closer is gonna help. Move closer. Missed him. Punch in the head, almost dead. Let's get him to here. Yeah, that'll be good cover. Let's still have her punch the crap out of this guy. Rafik lowers his gun, his brows furrowed. His voice is clear. What do you think? I see pals of that guy who tried to geek you last time. I was trying to geek you. It never ends, does it? The more I put down, the angrier the rest get. Our luck will run out long before they run out of box. I'm like, which one do I like? That's the job. We knew the deal when we signed up. I suppose we might as well try and get what we can out of it. This Rafik, he's a cool guy. Hey, I think that one's still moving. How do you want to handle this torture? ganger alone. Call medic? Yeah, let's call the medic. Who is this? Big tough world out there, you know. Maybe, I don't know, maybe he'll be reformed, or maybe his mom will be like so grateful she'll give me enchiladas, you know, like a whole like bucket full. I'll be so happy. Watch your step, fool. Don't enter raided territory unless you want a beating. I go where I please. Should I be afraid? I don't have time for this attack. Should I be afraid? Somebody from the outside is welcome here, especially no corpse sucker. Let's make a deal. I'm gonna do something you want. Bend forward. Do I look like someone you want to mess with? Simple step before I put you down. Looks like I need to teach you some respect, attack. Sorry, pal, but I'm going through you one way or another, attack. I didn't really want to come this way. Alright, I could take you. Good luck for you. But lucky for you, I'm feeling lazy tonight. Move your ass along, woman. Mm-hmm. Come again. I wanted to go back this way because the objective is over here. See the yellow line? It means that your objective is somewhere over here. But I guess I have to go around. I guess I am going through these guys. Oh, alarm? The bomb! Too late. You spot the barrel in the middle of the parking lot. Full of oil. The barely visible microtransmitter. A light blinking off. Oh, is she dead? Oh my god. Is that the end of my campaign? Oh, you remember nothing. It all ends. But how could you have known that it ended? Unless it started again. A thought. You grasp onto it, clinging desperately as it pulls you back to its consciousness. I think I must exist. I may still live. You know, there was no way she could avoid that. She was gonna hit that thing. She got plat. She got turned into a freaking oil slick. Excuse me. As you drift back into consciousness, you hear a familiar voice nearby.
Comes around.
Voice. Don't know. Maybe another 5 minutes or so? Give it time, after all. It took Lazarus 4 days. The voice drops another octave lower, trembling with anger.
I swear, if you're jerking me around after all I paid you.
If I walk out there, those two are gonna be talking to each other. Something lit over here. Like a cigarette or something. Look at this, she's hurt. Walking hurt. What the heck is that? What's that thing buzzing around? Oh, it's a roach. I'm stealing medkits left and right. I'm stealing cred sticks too. Give a shit. Everything's gotta go right into my hands. Nothing over here, okay. Seems to be somebody smoking a cigar over here. Yeah. I'm fine, I'm just all beat up. So Rafik. Hi, Sreya. I almost thought I wouldn't see you again. I thought I was gone for good. Seems about to embrace you, then he hesitates. I'm not sure how fragile you are. You can give me a hug, you fuck. Well, that's something three of us should chat about. Woman. My tattoo says fighter. Rafik, who's your friend? Could I be standing up? What exactly did you do to me? You were in an awful state when you arrived. The ancients would say that it wasn't even you. No heartbeat, limited brain functions. And then there was the little matter of most of your skin missing. Ugh. It was a bad scene. I had to rush you over. And this was the closest clinic available. Crikey! Unfortunately for you, I had a patient die under my knife just yesterday. Had a whole fresh cadaver available with spare parts, along with a few gigas of my own invention. Gigas? Unfortunately, the operation was incomplete. We're using 2030s tech to patch you up. And that tissue is going to die fast unless we get some acclimizers onto your bloodstream, into your bloodstream. I'm your last patient. Where can I get an acclimizers? Spellcasting, conjuring, chi casting. Is this going to mess with my essence? As little as possible. I better not. It's just a skin graft. She responds, as little as possible. Rafik here warned me that you're a spellslinger. So I tried to make the surgery as minimally invasive as possible. There's no metal in you, just raw people parts and some bits of bioware. Nice. What happened to your last patient? Chiwei's engineer came, name of Cameron. Got offered a fantastic job by a hotshot Silicon Valley firm, but was locked into a long-term contract. Backed up by dermal implants. She was going for a total body makeover that would let her disappear into a new corporate world. They had neglected to mention that she was allergic to peanuts. I like to snack while I work. Oh my god. Where do I get acclimizers? You can't, but I can. Spent the last decade building up a network that gets me illicit supplies with no questions asked. I say the word, I hand over the creds. You get the inputs. That will let you live. What is this going to cost us? Ah, now that's really an interesting question. See, I already have plans for those parts. Some Johnson came in here this morning, offered a serious bank for them. No questions asked. Your problem is to clear up a few minor outstanding legal issues for me. So far, so good, until your partner came in here and made a competing counter offer. That was a shotgun in your face, more like. Indeed you did. Indeed you did. The fact is, my Johnson isn't going to be happy. I could do with them for you. But you need to make it worth my time. I gave up a big payday to save your life. And I don't work pro bono. So what's the figure? $250,000. She owes my life. His face grows pale, shock and rage. What? $250,000. Look, a simple arithmetic. You wrecked a deal that was worth 200,000 yen. You have my IP inside your body. I need to deal with a very scary looking man who probably works for Eris and call in favors to ensure that your body keeps working past the end of the month. But you already took all the yen I have, yes. That was just to get your friend through the door. As soon as I cut part of that cadaver, you were on the hook for the rest. But we can apply your life savings as a credit towards the final payment. Let's say your life savings. Let's say 215,000 yen, new yen. Holy crap. Rafiki, motherfucker, you really paid for my operation? I think he's in love. What's to stop us from just killing you? You really pay for my operation? Yeah. Look, I've had my back. You've had my back so many times. You couldn't just let you bleed out like that. It's only money. It's worth it to save your life. But this doesn't mean that Korra. Yeah. We're back to square one on saving up for the operation. Her operation. You know Korra, though. She would have insisted on it if she was here. Always putting yourself last. I'm glad you helped me, man. Thanks a lot. What would you call them, Melix? They didn't lift a finger to help one of us. They've been in the job. In case you forgot, we're Shadowrunners. We are. The whole point of them hiring us instead of sending in our own goons was that we're expendable, disposable. Providing Doc Wagner support would impact their account. What about the cost of savings we offer? They're just crackers, ladies and gentlemen. So I have four responses here. I'm not going to pick them all. They tend to go in the same direction, and I don't know. I'm not going to say what's stopping us from killing you, because who would ask that? Like, what do you need to know? I'm just going to say, I should have gone into your line of work. It does have its perks, which almost makes up for the psychos who barge in demanding that you renege on deals with big corporate clients. Let's get out of here, Blackstar. We'll figure something out. Controllers and Octodox and a complete surgery has granted you a new ability, Adrenaline Rush. Available from your cyberware options while in combat. This is a high-risk, high-reward choice that grants you additional AP at the cost of ongoing damage. Ouch. Nice. It really looks good. I mean, it's all the rooms look sort of hand drawn, which I kind of like. He's blocking all weird. Oh. White pain unexpectedly arcs through your entire body. You let out a gasp as you stumble. Your feet grabs you before you reach the ground. Ooh. I say, are you okay? It hurts. Just hold it together, champ. We can't let you slip away from this world quite yet. And secretly, I love you. Just think of all you have left to do. See a dragon, trend on Trilly Tidil, get the hell out of Oakland, lick my ass. I mean, watch that, read that book, look at this book, I think it's called. We really need to get back to my place. Cora will have some ideas. She's a wizard at managing chronic pain after all she's been through. And finally, I can get my dream of menage a trois between you and her going. Oh, I didn't say that out loud. I'm writing this novel in my head of you and my wife. Oh! Casa de Cora. You retreat to Rafik and Cora's apartment. Meet your relief and your miraculous survival quickly decays into dread as you ponder the few options available to escape from this mess. I wonder if these guys created some of their own assets in here. They look good. It is literally like a throwback to the old early 90s games. Ding ding, getting some karma. I'm gonna have to train some of that karma here before I get going. Any chance your pals at the People's University could finish up the surgery thing? He shakes her head sadly. You in a fucking wheelchair? If you'd gotten her into the clinics right away, then maybe, but even that's unlikely. They're hella good at patching up holes from port bullets and maybe singed fingers from bomb manufacturing gone awry. Replacing someone's entire dermis, though. That's dock wagon territory. At this point, you're committed to Tolar, like it or not. No way Estrella can ditch that transplant and start all over again. Sorry, honey. How about the folks that have Halfer Village? Oh, fuck, fucking hard to say. I'm afraid the entire dwarves, the fine dwarves of Halfer Village, aren't terribly enthused on performing free surgeries for any troll who walks in the door. They owe me some favors, but not big enough for this. How are you feeling, Cora? I feel like somebody just peeled off my skin and then put it back on with Elmer's glue. How about you? How you doing? My legs are much better today, Estrella. Thanks for asking. How about your monstrous-looking skin? Rafik gazes protectively at her. I swear, if I ever find the assholes who started dumping chems into the Richmond soil... Cora, she snorts. You'd need the time machine to do anything about it. That shit's been going on since before I was born. I just had the misfortune of spending enough time there in a tiny enough body for it to do some real damage. Really? Dwarves are resistant to poisons! If you're going to get all knightly shining armor, do it for the kids growing up there now. They have more to lose than I do. I love the writing of these things. These guys are not bad. Rafik. Not as much as me, he tenderly smiles at her. You think too little of yourself, sweetie. You'd be lost. We'd be lost without you. I'm gonna bone you later. Yeah, though your legs don't work, you're gonna feel it. Because I'm a troll, and I'm hung like a fucking bear. And I know that's how you like it, baby. Okay, so then, got any more savings stashed away? Look at me hitting them up for money. Like, yeah, you got any more money you can give me? I could use all the money you got. God, I like how they give you these choices too. You can be, there's another one I was playing where you can be really kind of comical and crazy. We'll need to raise the funds elsewhere. You two have done enough already. You see, so you go, it's kind of like you go from like, hey, give me your money to help me get the money to you guys, I don't need you guys' help. I hate being the center of attention, but luckily for something like this. Okay. Oh, you poor dear. Yeah, that really helps, Cora. Thanks. Didn't ask for any of this, but like it or not, you're the most interesting thing that's happening right now. So brainstorming time. How could we go about raising several hundred thousand new yen? You can get a loan, yeah. Gansus and the Gunner must be holding some cash. They wouldn't report if it was missing. We get some local merchants, grab some goods. Why not grab Shiwani? Shiawazi? Maybe we can find some lucrative work. Here we go. Let's hit the gangsters up. I'm not sure if you'd like the implication that stealing from these poor sods would be a victimless crime. They're gangsters. Odds are good that their money is dirty, but you never know. In any case, it's too little of it and too spread out. We've done okay out on the streets, but busting into heavily armed strongholds, we'd be lucky to survive 60 seconds. Hold on, what about if you hit that train? Which train? The train, dummy, the one that would get blown up every day if you and Estrella didn't ensure that they clear paths with the gauntlet. Sorry, baby, that's what we call a passenger train. This isn't exactly a Royal Mail. The Royal Mail. It doesn't just carry wage slaves, it has some cargo too. Any mail on the trains is court money. Between kidnapping, theft, we can probably make it worth our while. Between kidnapping and theft. Yeah, you know, you're right. Between kidnapping and theft, we can make it worth our while. Hey, Noodles, how the hell did you... The chat changed locations. What's up, Noodles? Why is your chat in the middle of my screen? How did you end up over there? Oh, there you are. Okay. There you are. I found you now. Yeah, move you. Gotta move this over. Come on, man. How did you end up over here? There it is. Put it over here. That's good. Well, welcome back home. Yeah, I got bored. Oh, well, I'm sorry to hear that. I should be fine tomorrow. So you gonna lay down for a bit? I would. The Shiawassee Express runs between downtown and Walnut Creek. Walnut Creek. It mostly just carries corp workers safely across Oakland, but when the corp needs to move cargo in the same direction, it's cheaper for them to add a freighter to the car than to run a separate train. Yay! And I just came for a bit longer than usual. Gotcha. Well, I'm probably going to run this for a little while here for about half an hour or so. Probably do one more battle and then I'll head to bed. And I imagine security would be lower on a passenger line, right? Like if I were planning on how to rob this train. You're really getting into this. Yeah. We'll have some more guards to watch the cargo itself, but they're always skimped. They always skimped the security for that rail line. Witness our present employment. I like this idea. After all, it's because of the corp job that you got in the situation in the first place. And knocking over the train isn't going to take food off anyone's table. At the worst, it'll shave a fraction of the percentage point off the share price. This sounds like our best option. If you had to win a game, I'm in. I always wanted to pull off a heist. Let's go with that one. Hold up there. I can't deny this. The idea is exciting, but let's face the facts. If robbing the train was easy, someone would have done it by now. What do they have that we don't? What do we have that they don't? Inside info. That's what we got. Ground level knowledge of the gauntlet. Post-surgery freak with nothing to lose. Inside information about the train operations. True. The devil only got us so far. I mean, they tell us the timelines, and I can sometimes pry a few more secrets from loose dispatch, but that's about it. If we really are going to do this, we need to go much deeper. Duty rosters, access codes, the works. Please don't tell me that you two are going to do this yourselves. I mean, don't get me wrong, but you're very talented and all that, and I'm sorry, what you do and all that. But this seems like it will require some specialized help. Do you know of any hotshot Decker who can get us into Shiawassee systems? She's a Decker, isn't she? Or do you have any friends at People's University or October 25 Alliance? Might help us out. Lots of Deckers were happy to crack a secured node if you steal some embarrassing secrets for the quick payday. Not many who would want to risk tangling with Black IC in a secured megacorp system, though there's one guy who passes through the PU a few months ago, named Sable. He was definitely looking for a challenge. I think he moved on because our stuff was small scale. table. That rings a bell. I wrote a couple of young hoppers in the gauntlet throwing that name around. New toy of their boss who was springing their boys from the stock market. It must be hot if he can remotely override lockdown, even the broke city like Oakland. Oakland. Recruit the Decker. It's my next objective. Or it might be the same guy. You should check him out. Maybe he can get you in, or at least point you in, point you to someone else who can. What if there's a safe to blow? An explosive specialist would be handy. We'll need experts on train. Some whiz, big iron rig. Yeah, rigger would be nice. I got nothing. Kids around here only care about drones. Barely ever see anyone who's rigging an auto, let alone a locomotive. Wait, Estrella, who was that rigger you ran into in Alameda? The one who helped us chase down the NTTs. She was California, a California Ranger at the time, but I think she's moved on. Some maniac, she'd be perfect. That's right. It seemed adept at operating multiple passenger vehicles at once. That's probably our best lead. Bit of rigor. Oh, we're gonna get five people? What if this is safe to blow and explosive specialist would come in handy? Cora, who was that pyro you were talking about the other day? Oh yeah, the Phoenix. He rolled into Halfville. And it's really making a splash among the popular. Sounds like a real loose cannon, but I think that's exactly what we're looking for. Someone who is making gigantic explosions and isn't terribly concerned about the consequences. I still think it just sounds nuts, but I'm excited. It'll be nice to shoot skeet for once instead of being the clay pigeon. Who do you want to go after first? This is not going to be a fight. This is going to be a fetch quest. Let's try to find the rigger first. I was going to go for the Decker. Sounds good. I'll hold on the fort from here. Hey, where else are you going to go in that wheelchair? Nowhere. Here's lots of our savings. Rafik, you should hire another runner to come with you. What you're doing is hella dangerous, and there's no shame in asking for help. Oh, and don't forget to bring along those med kits. We're stuck by them for a reason, after all. Okay, you have to be careful now. You dodged death once. I doubt you'll be so lucky again. Don't worry, Cora. I'll keep an eye on her. I guess I'm secretly one of them. I want you guys to secretly want to have a menage with you. That's what I'm trying to say. God damn, she like stomps everywhere. Check out the stash. What you got there? I like this. I'll take that. Because I need one of those. I will also replace this with this. I think I know drugs. What's wrong with them? Alright, let's put another one on. This point here. Got no drugs. Alright, let's take it all. Yeah, let's take everything. We don't need. Alright, well thanks for everything, Cora. Thank you. I hope you you get other stuff? Shopping terminal. Welcome to Speedy Delivery, answering connect to local merchants in your area. With decent goods at a reasonable price. Very reasonable time. Well, what can I order? Hold on, before I go into this. This is the best thing about this game is you can press escape and still stay in the interface, either the vendor interface or the chatting interface with whoever you're talking to. So if you're about to get in the fight, you can kind of see where you're at, what your equipment is, and kind of where things are, you know, kind of where they stand. So where was she? Oh, look at her. We got up. Okay. Yeah, I'm not flipping around. What am I looking at here? I wanted to see what she's got. That's right. I wanted to see what. First, I wanted to see her ability. I think she's got unarmed, no melee weapons. Thrown weapons at 2. So yeah, I'm not gonna spend karma yet, but you can buy a weapon. Pulse. Is it all guns? No, it's not. A kunai. All there is a kunai, and that's it. Well, it's expensive, though. That's taking a big chunk of my freaking pay here. Outfits. Street funk here. Casting. I guess, can I use this? No, I'm not ready. But maybe. And consumables are these guys. Okay. So all I'm going to buy is the knife. Because I could use it. What is policy? Speed of Delivery is a cooperative venture of the October 25th Alliance. We work hard to connect orcs, trolls, and other metas with merchants and consumers in their local neighborhoods. Remember, a dollar paid to our megacorps is a dollar that will be spent to oppress you. Keep your hard-earned money in your own community. Shop local. Shoot, San Francisco. What does that mean? Shoot, San Francisco. That sounds a bit violent. All right, give me a second here. But I always thought it would be nice with I think we're Fallout 3 kind of missed a mark in the kill cam. If you remember Fallout 3, Fallout 4 I think still has it too, and so does Skyrim. But Bethesda just made that like a thing. I mean, I know a lot of games have kill cams, but holy crap, do they have kill cams with the yin yang? So, but I think where they went wrong is they could have kept this sort of isometric view. Some of the games, I think some games could really benefit from this. And I see it, I think Silent Storm might have had a kill cam, but I'm forgetting which game with isometric view had a kill cam, but you can zoom in during combat and kind of cinematically show like a kill shot instead of, being so sort of static, it could be more dynamic. Okay, so I'm not going to spend a bunch of money. What I'm going to do before I head out to, this over here is where you can train your team. So I can actually train him. He gained a level. It's level 2. So, Man of Action, gain item Jazz. He's only gonna go up 4 levels. Okay, so we might as well make this quick. Gold Dock Wagon. Let's do that. Let's confirm it. I didn't know I had to click it twice. Yeah, I think I may go the whole shaman route with him and not much else. So that's it. You only get one guy you can train. I may be able to train the Decker once I find him. But I have to find him first. But if you're looking close, I love the detail in here. Like the Mystique poster, the little teddy bear. Teddy bear doesn't look very three-dimensional. It almost looks like I can fade right through him. Or I can flip right through him. Still, there's a lot to be said for a game like this one. What are we doing here? Talk to him. Estrella, how much better? You look much better than before. How are you feeling? Are you feeling like shit? Well, at least you don't look like getting it anymore or smell it. We've been running together for what, 5 years now? You're like a sister to me that like to blow. Oh, what? Blow? What am I talking about? You're like a sister to me. I think you're having a dick. and I trust you with my own life, but I still don't feel like I really know you. Oh, yeah, that's another thing that this game does a lot of. And during the downtime, you can skip all of it. You don't have to do all that shit. But in the downtime, you can do this like real deep character exploration. It's kind of good if you're into like nested dialogues. Man, if you love nested dialogues, you'd love the shit out of this game. See, I already have three choices. I feel I really know you. That's because you were professionals. All you had to do was ask. Does anybody really know anyone else, though? I mean, really? Really know them? You know what I mean? Where's that from? Where's that from? You really, really know them? Where's that from? From The Godfather? No, I gotta look that up, because that's actually from a movie. That's very smart right there. It's from a movie. Never really know anyone else. Movie. Rules of Attraction. Good Will Hunting. That's supposed to be. I think this was in a movie. Why is this coming up for videos? A Case for Christ. This guy Superstar Live in Concert. Somebody that I used to know. Does anyone ever really know anyone else? Does anybody? No, okay, that's not the quote that she's. Does anyone really? Okay, that's, I think it's from a song. Does anyone really ever get to? No, does anyone ever really get to? That's not what I mean. Movie. Okay, there we go. Everybody knows this quote. Nobody knows where it's from. Without searching the internet, character, so what does it do? It doesn't do anything. That's the beauty of it. That's actually kind of nice, but that's not what I'm looking for. Does anyone ever really get? No. Let's try again. Can you ever truly know someone? Does anyone really know anyone? Odyssey. Rules of Attraction. Okay, well I'm gonna check it out. Well, this is 5 minutes long though. How old is this movie? 2002. I'm trying to see if I can hear this part that they're talking about.
Fucking Victor.
Yeah?
What the fuck are you writing me letters?
Wow. Deal with it, Sean. It's over. Rock and roll.
Lauren, I want to know you.
What does that mean? Know me. Know me. Nobody knows anyone else, ever. You will never, ever know me.
Rules of Attraction, ladies and gentlemen. It's, I knew it was from somewhere, but I think it's been requoted. That's some freshman level bullshit right there. So what's the story? Why do you start running in the shadows anyways? Chose like me and exactly popular. I grew up poor, never had a sin. Shadow runners are the running of modern world. I always thought that sounded like an exciting life. I get to shoot people in the face and get paid for it. What's not to like? That's for me to know and for you to never find out. Man, she wants to be an enigma. I get to shoot people, but I don't shoot anybody because I'm not a shooter. Let me see. Here we go. Right there. Exciting, I guess so. You do know that Ronan didn't live very long, right? Suppose the best we can hope for is to leave behind a good story. But the thing that Ronan did not have a master. So if they had the resources to live, they could. Also, if they had the backup to live, they could. I suppose I should give you my own story. Is there a little bit of music playing, like a little ambiance movie? It's kind of pretty light. Yeah, I think it's just, there is music back there, huh? Weird. Let's see. That's... Yeah, okay. Anyways, I have to spend those points, but it's not super exciting, and it's a lot of like, should I do this, or should I do that, or should I do this? I suppose I should give you my own story. You're probably piecing it together by now, anyways. I grew up here in Oakland, also known as Orkland. My whole family is Ork, and well, you know that kind of what kind of lives are available to Orks around here? Hard muscle, freelance thievery, organized crime isn't exactly the stuff people are proud of. Because we're big and burly. My siblings all joined various local gangs. I'm the youngest, and saw firsthand how brutal that life is. Recruits spend all day hustling on the street, keep only a sliver of what they earn, and are the first to die whenever trouble starts. I wanted something better. So, I started taking classes at the People's University. Practical stuff. How to avoid marine patrols, where to scavenge free food, what shops will sell to people without sin, which are pretty much called sinless. I also met other orcs who had started their own businesses, or who had traveled to the East Coast, or even worked as consultants in corps in the city. I decided that I was going to beat the odds and become the best orc I could be. That's right, army of one. I met a couple of like-minded people at the PU. Became private security contractors, providing local knowledge and presence to outsiders who wanted to do business in Oakland. And then I met Cora. A small but brilliant grin rose into a toothy smile. I see. You two obviously care for each other. I still understand how an orc like you and a dwarf like her end up together, and that is a great question. She was one of my instructors, taught me how to use the Matrix, if you can believe it. 2 decades in this planet, and I never once saw the digital world. 2 decades, huh? We just clicked instantly. She's the sort of woman you dream about after watching too many treads. Kind, funny, thoughtful, brave. I'm still amazed that she saw anything in an oaf like me. The day she agreed to date was the happiest of my life. And I've had many more happy days since then. And it's odd because I'm going out with a woman, yet I've never felt more gay. Rafik breathes a contented sigh. A contented sigh. How about you, Australia? Do you ever dream of finding a nice piece of ass to fuck? a piece of person, yep. Person, yep. Hang in there, lady. I'm sure you'll meet that special someone sooner or later. I meant the puppy, you mofo. Anyways, as you have no doubt noticed by now, Tui Cora is an idealist. She understands the realities of Oakland, but she also believes that we should act to improve them. We've had some long talks, and decided that she keep teaching at the university while I focus on work that helps keep people safe rather than put them in danger. An ironic grin flashes across Rafik's face. Of course, I didn't expect those people to be corporate suits. With Cora's medical bills coming due every month, we needed a steady paycheck. Which Shadow Runner's work is feast or famine? You get a big score, then you try to live it on it as long as you can until the next one comes around. The corpse always desperate for help. The gauntlet, though, while the pay isn't great, reliable. Bar wasn't too happy at first. If only the face of her self-sufficient anti-corporate principles. We had a long talk and decided that it was best for her. For us. My responses. See, that's the thing. Like, so many necessary. I could go deep into these, but just pick one and move on, man. It's, if it gives you the option to go through them, you can go through them all, but I'm not going to do that. That's stupid. You should give up your freedom to support someone. You shouldn't give up your freedom to support someone else. If I had someone like Cora in my life, I would have made the same sort of sacrifice. I guess that Cora's idealism didn't mean anything after all. Oh my god. The first one and the third one are like low blows. You could do a lot more with your skill. I admire the decision you made. These two are like, I kind of wish I could bow. Yeah, there we go. Drugs, contentedly. I could earn more. What would be the point? I'm very happy with the life I built with Cora. I get much more satisfaction coming home to her after a long day of getting shot at than I would hold up in some gang or stronghold like my brother. Enough talk. I guess we understand each other better than before. Good thing, too. We'll be seeing even more of each other until this thing is done. It's important that we know what kind of woman is by my side. So is he coming with me? Okay, companion favor. Your companions will pay attention to your words and action. Your decisions The decisions you make will improve or damage their opinion of you. Disgruntled companions will still follow you, but may eventually leave if you continue to antagonize them. Keeping your crew happy will help ensure their support and loyalty. If you ever played, what's the other one? God damn it, I forget shit sometimes because I'm not here fully at times. Dragon something or other, tell me. Is it up here? Shadow of this Hong Kong Sprawl Gangers. It was. I mean, I love all this shit. This world is so deep. That's what I really love about it. That's also kind of the problem. Dragonfall. That's kind of the problem with it. Like, it's so deep, and the people that are in there are so. That's so the scarily otaku about it. So now I can go and chat it up with Cora if I want to, but Cora's in a wheelchair, so I doubt it. I doubt it will be taking on any runs. Hi there, Estrella. Good to see you on your feet again. Rafik told me all the gory details. He may not show it, but he was hella shaken up by what happened. I haven't seen him that obsessed since, well, never. Well, the skin hanging off my face should make you feel it more appetizing. I'm lucky he was there. He's a good orc. I guess orc means like orcs and trolls. I guess they're like the orc race. But I don't really haven't looked into that. I could literally have and do this right now. I could have the wiki open and look at stuff and answer questions and no thanks. This is a deep world. Yeah, let's see. No half-breeds exist. Yeah, there's a lot of that. They didn't tell me anything about orcs. He's a good orc. Oh, I don't know. Don't I know it? He still finds new ways to impress me. I'll be teaching you some more classes at Big Blue University in a bit. But first, I wanted to greet you and make sure you were doing okay. You're welcome to stay here with me and Rafik for as long as you need. Our place isn't very spacious, but it's safe. And since you two will be working closely together, you might as well keep an eye on each other. I would like it if you like tried to like make the moves on her. Or if you could try to make the moves on him and see how that went. I'd like to try my hand at some of this stuff. I know I tried my hand at the Neverwinter, the Foundry. I'm still going to work on that, but that's a good idea, making things like uncomfortable. Yeah, that'd be nice. What classes are you leading now? I have a few sessions in my intro level matrix course, basic safety skills, jacking protocols, navigating hosts, things like that. Some of my alumni are looking for more advanced work, so I've now started offering seminars in evading IC and deploying ESPs. Or those experts. Honestly, you're still not rocket science. If someone's a true decker, they'll figure out all this stuff on their own much more quickly than I could teach it to them. But the matrix is a fact of life. It lets the folk need to deal with it even if they don't want to become experts. Hopefully my classes help make the digital life a bit less arcane for the masses. Where will you be teaching? Right here. There's no physical campus for the PU. Almost all of our classes are virtual, especially matrix ones like mine. Ah, I get it. There are a few ad hoc distributed groups that will meet up in person. That's really helpful for classes while vehicle repair. But since Sato is cracking down on the PU, we need to be careful to never meet in the same place more than twice. What does Sato have against the PU? I think he lumps us with the October 25th Alliance and the MetaHuman Project. People's Army has dangerous militants trying to oust him from power, which is patently ridiculous, of course. The PU is proudly pacifist, but we're going to go and heist the train. Even if he didn't believe we were secretly plotting his downfall, though, he would probably still feel threatened. We seek to educate and help everyone, but the people who benefit the most are Sato's natural foes, dispossessed, poor orcs, trolls, and dwarves, who he shoved out of San Francisco and into the slums of Oakland. Oh, so that's what's going on in Northern California. At least, in this story, huh? That's a lot of exposition. That's a lot of exposition that happens when you're actually, like, engaged in dialogue. I guess there could have been better ways of saying it. Because this could take all night. There's a lot of dialogue in this fucking game. Individually, these people are no danger to him. He can crush them at any time. But he faces a knowledgeable, prepared, effective populace that he will find it much more difficult to expand his domain. Thanks for letting me crash here. Of course, Australia, if you're like family to us, enjoy your stay. My husband wants to bang it. So if you want to give it up, I'm so good. I'll just copy it. Have fun! Oh, that's right, I read that. He like stomps everywhere. I think all trolls like stomp everywhere. At least she's not looking injured. Alright, so what I'm gonna do now is save it. I think here. Yeah, I think I wanna save it. And I wish I could call it something, but I think I can't. Yeah, you can see I have a lot of saves. You can, with the stories that are in the game, I think I want to create a story where you just go on like a similar mission or kind of a mission over and over and over again. See how that goes. Because I'm doing something similar like that for the Foundry right now. I'm not going to hire anybody. Tattoo circuitry. No, I'm gonna take the free guy and keep the money. Cause see, I mean, he's a shaman. That's enough. And I'm gonna go find my, I'm not gonna spend it. Finish it, yes, be a samurai. This guy wouldn't be bad for what we're trying to do. I'm not gonna hire two, but I don't wanna use up all my money. Drone. Mage. Let's pick this three samurai, okay? God, he's really loaded. He's loaded for bear. The last 2 days have been a blur. Percy remembers you from your last encounter and agreed to meet you, but only you, if you meet her on board a cargo ship departing for Port of Oakland tonight. No details, but something in her voice told you that it would be a good idea to bring along your weapon. And again, it's always a good idea to bring along your weapons, especially to the Port of Oakland. Vast quantities of legitimate shipping goes through here, but even more is smuggling, contraband, or worse. Organized crime syndicates from both sides of the bay keep watch here, protecting their investments and capitalizing on opportunities. You hope that whatever Percy has in mind doesn't end with you on the seabed, or anybody else for that matter. Let's try to keep hope alive. So again, put this over here. Can we move this over here? Move this over here? No. No. I should put one of these here. El Duce. I didn't even catch his real name. I don't think they didn't show his real name. Let's confirm this bitch. We'll get some music, I think. Oh, I got that itch again on my foot. You have karma available to improve your character's attributes and skills. Open the karma screen. Ooh. Yeah, let's do that. Because I haven't done that yet. And then I need to save the game. I did save the game, that's right. And so I have a save before I used any of these points. But I wanted to point out. So here I can use 7 points to improve quickness. I have strength, I can use 3 for that. 7 points there. Or 5 points. No, I can't use 5 points there. I can also display it. Distraction does 1 AP damage, reduces HP damage by 3, so you don't take as much damage, is that right? Let's increase the unarmed. Overwatch? That'd be nice for throwing weapons. 3 and 4 is 7. Yeah, we'll work on quickness next time. And wisdom that gives us spell casting right here. Okay. It should have also auto-saved. That's the thing, is that if you look here and load the game, you'll see that there's a load out to sea, which is what I'm on right now. But this is actually before I spent the points too. So I'm kind of go back. I kinda wanna just hit a quick save here. There we go, and just leave that. So I think I'm pretty happy with what I have so far. Where are we going anyway? So God, it feels like it's loud, damn it. I did turn it up. I turned it up, that's fine. What's our mission? Objectives out to sea, unless it is in a blur. I'm supposed to meet Percy, that's right. Let's go this way if I can. Oh, no entry without authorization. Oh, this guy over here. This dog's in shit. Dogs. There's no way to look around or see what's up. What is this? Pack dog. There's a security captain. There's security here. So I guess we're going in gangbusters, aren't we? Can I leave? I can't leave. I gotta do this. Yeah, I don't have a choice. It all seems pretty calm from here. Still the new yen, and everybody goes insane. Holy shit. Okay, well, maybe I'll restart this, because that seemed like a bit of a trap on my side. I didn't really intend to kill all these guys, or to even try to kill all these guys. Three against what? We got six, right? There's one, two, three, one, two, three. I don't even know who these people are over here. Yeah, let's restart. Okay, here. Oh no, that's right. Let's do, I think it's F9, right? That's right. Yeah, that's the quick save right there. Yeah, it's funny because she tells me, like, that's a bit of a bug, though. She tells me, like, you don't belong in here, and then you're, like, walking around like an idiot. But the new one just sitting on the captain's like, that does it. You're going down. Out of your shit. Did we tell you to leave already? Oh, no entry without authorization. Excuse me, I must have gotten turned around. Okay, then I'm just going to continue going. Through here. How you see this? Okay, yeah, you do. And then you run into the smugglers. Hello, smuggler. What's up, baby?
Well. What a surprise to see another law-abiding citizen skulking around the port late at night. What brings you here, friend? I could ask you the same thing. We need to get on that boat. Ah, that's interesting.
I wonder if all trolls talk like that. Like, yeah, that's really heavy. Brr. Look at this elf over here. God, I wish I could zoom in more. Now, this is interesting. Myself, I need to get something off that boat. We've been waiting to slip past the guards, but they're uncannily diligent today. I have a proposition for you. Attack the guards. My guys will cut the comms in this area and make sure reinforcements don't arrive. After they are taken care of, we'll grab a couple. Maybe I should have got another Shadow Runner. There's no way I'm gonna be able to take out all these guys with three guys. After they're taken care of, we'll grab a couple of containers, which I might add, we already paid for, and we'll be on our way. Even if we slip you a little something for your trouble. Let's see if we can do this. We have a deal? I have another proposition. Fight along without us. We ain't exactly equipped for that sort of work. Carrying heavy fire gets you stopped. And search in question. We're more for the slip and slip out kind of guys, which ain't much use in a firefight. We're staying out of this one if we can help it, of course. If you spotted, all bits are off. Hey, smugglers and pirate security and everything. Have a brutal die and attack everyone. Oh my god. Let's see what we can do here. This is gonna be three of us. I don't know how we're gonna do it, but yeah, I think I may have bitten off more than I could chew. See, that's the thing, is that he's got really good combat, really into combat, and you sometimes get your ass kicked. I was actually gonna train before she left, but I wasn't planning on taking two extra paid shadow runners, because that's like almost all the money she gave me. But you know, I don't, I guess I should. So I have 800. I really don't buy much of anything here. I think I have 800 new yen. Magical equipment, medical supplies. Yeah, you see, I have 554. Yeah, let's medical equipment. It's expensive. But these I can do, because they need spell casting. Conjuring. Okay, well, shit. Medical. Any drugs in here? No, no chems. No. Okay, so I have enough for two guys. Shit. I'm gonna have to do this shit all over again. Yeah, it's all good. It's all good. We know what we did last time, anyways. It was not body, it was not strength. It was unarmed, close combat. I put 2 points in spellcasting, but I still don't have the spells to use. I don't want to put them in there, they're kind of useless there. Put it, I already have this, I don't need that. I don't have enough for this, or I don't want anything like this. Huh. I think it would be nice. Where am I going after this? Gangs of security. Shadow runner. I didn't get a choice before, that's weird. Gang. Security. Security since, yeah, they're run a cops. All right, and that confirms it. Yeah, just a tiny bit in freaking, whatchamacallit, and charisma. Not a ton. Save that right here. All right, let's go out. But let's put him back. Yeah, I guess if I'm picking up four of them, because if I just pick up her, what does she look like? He's like everything. A rigger and, let's put the samurai there. The rigger next. Well, I can only take three people. What the fuck? Okay, then I'm taking this girl. Okay. Long. Yeah, that works. Yeah, you stay back. Holy crap. She's styling. But yeah, let's confirm this. Yeah, I guess I. Jesus, the first mission is to take all the security guys. That's crazy. I thought you could take another runner with you, and you can't. You got the money for it, so now I think, shit, now I want to go back. It's not going to just bought equipment. Here, let's just go. Now I got to go back. Now that I know that I can only take one shadow runner, I don't know why they don't cover that last spot at the end. Because I wouldn't have done that. I wouldn't have checked it. I wouldn't have tried to keep on going. Ah, fucking A. That's alright. Take a moment. At least I already trained, so I don't have to freaking redo that again. But now I'm gonna buy some shit, now that I know that 250 can't be spent on anything but equipment. Might as well do that. Yeah, so I can actually pick up a spell if I want it. Yeah, there we go. I don't have any conjuring, but fireball sounds okay. I could have also picked up some gear, but I don't think I'll pick that up. So I have 100 I could use here. Isn't this a spell? This is a confirm it. And then we'll leave and oh shit, did I spend too much? I'm such an idiot. Oh my god, because if I wanna take her, I can't spend all that money. Oh shit. That's what save games are all about. Is to fix your mistakes in life. Oh hold on, did I just save the fucking game? Oh god damn it. Did I just save the fucking game? Okay, well, then now I'm just fucked. Yeah, I saved the game and then loaded. Yeah, saved it. So I used up that money. I can't sell it back, can I? No. Oh, does it give you the option to sell it? I don't think so. Cyberware status. Total technology. Yeah, 254, so I guess I'm taking one of the cheaper guys with me. But we got plenty of shit. We got plenty of other stuff, so. God damn, okay, here we go. See, that's what happens when you fuck around, man. So I guess I'm taking you, Dulce. You're coming anyways. Shit, I really wanted her. Lucky strike. See what she was all about. Well, we're going cheap. What does he have over here? A machete? He got plenty of stuff. He needs to pick up some. Yeah, that's what are our choices at this point? I'm already fucked up. And I didn't pick a bit of grenades. Well, this is not gonna go too far anyway, so. So this is not like super hard. But I mean, fighting six guys at a security right away, that does not seem like a walk in the park. Oh man. Alright, let's see how this goes. Talk to this chick right here. Smuggler. Need to get in the boat. She doesn't need a boat. She wants to kill you. Another proposition. To get the gun, I don't need or want your help. Oh, did I just fuck it up with a smuggler? Shit. I'm just fucking it up with everybody, aren't I? The boat is back here. Get a security. Man, I don't know why, but I keep on fucking up and it's... Load game. Yeah, even the game's getting pissed off at me. Okay, we're ready. No more fucking up. We're on track now. I think I should still have a quick save. If I wanted to use it, but I think it's too late for that one. I think I got everything I wanted out of this one. Oh, I'm trying to get out of this, come on. Okay, so good luck. We got like how many of these guys do we have? At least the smugglers are not our enemy, so we don't gotta kill those guys too. But there's one, two, at least the ones in the tank over here. We could probably kill the dog. Get that new yin later. Okay, so he is gonna go. Can he hit that? Where he's at? Do I want him to? Yeah, because I wanna see. First, I have to make sure that everybody's positioned how I want them to. So these guys are over here. This guy's over here. I need them all to be like your freaking backs have to be covered. Okay, so there's three guys over here, but there's another guy I think that might be back here or something. Three guys right here. Her, the dog. What I can do, you can get here on one, right? Get there. That's a good angle too. That's a good angle too. Also, all in one. Jeez, this guy can move. Fucking A. But I wanted to be in defensive in case this girl goes loco. Put him right here. Got a shotgun, of course, three samurai. That's not very inspiring. I mean, a shotgun and a freaking machete. Talk about really trying hard to be a street samurai. Let's put him over here just to make sure he hit. He can hit. That he's covered. Let's make sure he's covered. That's what I'm thinking. And then she can go right here and be covered from all these guys. Right here. She's right here. I don't want to be too close. Because I think I can. Yeah, I can go right here and use this bolt to take out this can here and see if that does anything. At 88. Let's, before we do anything, what does he have? He has blur. His armor, but I need him to shoot something. Heals out. Let's go ahead and try it first with her. Let's see if she can knock both of these guys out. There we go. Nice, nice. Nice at taking damage. The dog is in medium cover. And shoot her. Though I don't care for the dog either. Jeez, what's her? Can he see her? How can his line of sight be blocked? Well, she's exposed right there, so I gotta either give her armor or give her blur. She has to be hit. Yeah, let's do that. Oh, set locked again. What the fuck can he do then? Yeah, he's under heavy cover. I don't want to waste a spell on him. Be sad to use an elemental right away. Really, it would be very sad to use them right away. But we need to get this done. That's what he can do right now. Wow. What was that all about? Okay, here's the dog. Why is he? Just for a second he got, yeah. When it goes to her, he gets that kind of. He moves, okay. He missed. Oh, she moved. Good. We're good. We're in a good place. Yeah, we're in a good place. Yeah, they're still pretty far off, so they're not gonna hit a goddamn thing. More after I put some some glitter on her. Good, hold on. Let's put, yeah, he's only got one, but let's go ahead and armor her up a little bit. The dog dead? Before he goes, let's go ahead and bring him up. There's a dog. There's a dog right there. Ouch. He's down for the count. Okay, so he needs to move somewhere. Where are these guys? They jumped in to help. Didn't have blur. I'm not blur, but thank you. Nice money coming in. Look at this shit. Oh, man. It's like 310. I completely forgot about that. I was like so into that fight. I completely forgot about the time. I doubt we'll ever see each other again, but if we do, I'll be happy to know that we can trust one another. After all of these for carnage. Attack! There should be some other options here, like, I don't know. Pickpocket would be nice for certain classes. Let's just do Pharaoh. That's the attack. I've developed an appetite for carnage. Yeah, I thought there was a guy there. Well, I almost forgot. I got something for you, Estrella. Here, right before we got on the boat. It's a bomb. Happy birthday. It gave me $200. I must have been gone so long as I thought. Well, not that long. You never told me when your birthday is, which means I owe you many missed gifts. This is so sappy, like right before we got on the boat. Your recent scare made me realize that I should do a better job of letting people know that I appreciate them while I still have the chance. I'll put this to good use with some whores and whiskey. After this is all done, maybe you'll let me know what your birthday actually is. I'm sure we can get one of the People's University speaking classes to make you a nice cake or something. That's very touchy, Rafik. I value your friendship. We're trolls. Make a great tea, Rafik. I'll return the favor one day. Rafik, are you trying to fuck me? We have more important things to worry about than cake. Just forget it. He claps you on the shoulder. There's nobody I'd rather have on my side. It's like a buddy cop. It's like a buddy cop Shadowrunners movie here. Of course, we need to make sure you have that operation if you're going to get another birthday. Onward, Dan. I think he's going to die. He's going to end up dying. Board the vessel. Are you ready to leave the port and meet Percy? I am. Is it shit as I can do? I already picked up. Let's see. Did I pick up everything? Yeah, I've been everywhere. It's nothing. Picked up the new yen and killed everyone. Everybody's dead. So, I think Alt is what you can press, yeah, to activate any things that I may not be able to see, but I think it's all good. I gotta get this done quick because I gotta get some sleep. This game is sort of like Civilization that way. You're like, one more turn. Just one more turn. Civilization, that's another one I want to play. Tug takes you out to CSS Sisyphus, which lies a short distance offshore. It has already been loaded up with cargo and is about to embark through the Golden Gate and on to its final destination. You quietly board at the aft of the vessel, avoiding the security agents patrolling the ship's perimeter. It wasn't too long ago that you had much the same job, and while you don't have much experience on the open water, you're very familiar with the standard security procedures and how to evade them. To begin to search for your rigger contact, you promised to meet you here. She's really taking me through. I think she's taking me in the middle of a job or something. I don't know what's going on here. This rigger is a pain in the ass. If nothing else, the game autosaves nicely enough. What is she, an orc? Or is she a troll? No, she's an orc. Not a troll, she doesn't have any horns. Blackstar, glad that you make it. Those fools on shore give you any trouble? Give you any trouble? No, I killed them all. What fools? Good. I need you to stay focused for the main show. Let's see. Oh, she's gonna be the fourth person that I couldn't bring with me. Let's see. When was the last time we met up? Just the once. About 2 years ago. The time we set off a bomb 3 meters from my face and dumped the San Francisco Bay in our heads. There we go. Right, right. Good times. Good time. Well, since then, the California Rangers and I have parted ways. I got bored with being stuck in Alameda. If they weren't so happy about me wandering into other Rangers' territory, this person my own brand of justice. So if you're hoping to use my connections to the Rangers, I'm afraid I burned those bridges. It isn't that. I need a rigger, take a passenger train. Actually, I was hoping you might help me with a train. Choo-choo! This should be part of a choo-choo, motherfucker. That's the sound of your future with us. Ugh, trains? It would be trains. Look, I'm sure you got a great lady and all, but I don't do trains. I hate the things. My vision of hell locked into a track going straight forward forever. Just be taking the train, not keeping it. Give you something more amusing to do. Think less tracks. Think more loot. I blame you. Wait, you're going to knock over a train? Well, that's different. Yeah, and it's got to be a corp train, right? That'll be sticking it to the man and showing everyone how totally lame trains are. Yep. I'll get behind that. Tell you what. You help me out with this little thing, and I can play engineer for your job. What little thing? Seems fair. Let me guess. I'm going to get shot at again. What little thing? I thought life after the Rangers would be fun. It is, mostly. But now that I can't legally shake down speeders anymore, my income's been drying up. She sighs wistfully. Gods, I miss my armored 18-wheeler, Jesus. Where was I? Oh yeah, right. I've been reduced to running tugs around the bay. Yeah, stuff it. I've heard it all before. It's okay work, except it's boring as hell, and they keep cutting my payback. Cutting your bay? How did they get away with that? I figure it's because they haven't seen my skills in action, so I goes, let's manufacture a little crisis. Put the fear in them. Make them feel grateful that Percy's on their payroll. What exactly are you asking me to do? What do you need from me? This sounds like an incredibly bad idea. I'm going with that one. The gesture serves the bow of the ship. Head over there, find the comlink, announce that you are pirates. Whoever they get over the ship. The man, I don't know, ransom or whatever. Holy crap. I'm hanging back in here all ladylike. Then when they start feeling the pressure and calculating their losses, I'll swing to action and pretend to throw you off the boat. Then be the hero of the day. Sound good? Is there anywhere else on the ship? What do you think the reaction will be? Why not just steal the cargo? Okay, let's do this. This is what it takes. I'm feeling lucky today. Is there anyone else on the ship? Yeah, a couple of guards. Not sure if they'll give you any trouble or not. No skin off my nose. What happens to them? Oh, no skin off my nose. What do you think the reaction will be? The cops are all paper pushers. They check the value of the cargo, cost of a response. They futz about their fingers up their asses. Once they're nice and panicked, I'll swoop in to save the day. Why not just steal the cargo? Sure, if you know anyone who wants to buy thousands of tons of timber. Not saying there aren't buyers, but I sure as hell don't know anyone local. That's where we're shipping it out of here in the first place. I'm feeling lucky today. Awesome! So I'll be waiting here quietly. I'm rigged to the local surveillance system, so I'll keep my eyes and ears on you. Good luck! Look at all the cables she's got coming out of her. Yeah, she's all rigged up. I love riggers, man. My first character was a rigger, and it was a lot of fun. Where are we going? Let's go over here. The pirates! Pirates coming through! The turbine service station. Okay, yeah, that's it. The etiquette that I picked, I'm not gonna read the other ones because that's kind of cheating. Etiquette security, your plane closed from East Bay Region Division heading to assignment at the Port Redwood City. Going up against those airs, boys. Hey, I don't envy you. Good luck. Yeah, I'm gonna be able to get by security pretty easy. That's the main reason why I picked it. Let's go this way. I love the music. What's going on, Hoth? State your purpose. Where plane goes. Okay, something. That's it? There's something too fishy about your crew. Take him down. Oh, what the fuck? Really? Holy shit. Oh man, I can't even hit the... Well, I guess I can... I need to have these guys take cover. Or at least figure out where cover is. There's solid cover right there for him. Peek, where do you got cover at? Oh, I guess he can summon a spirit. Yeah, let's have him do that. Move here. Ruffy. There, summon the spirit. There we go. And Typhoon. We'll kick some ass over here. I wonder if you can flank him. How many guys are out there? I thought there were like two or something like that. Yeah, there's no... Move this guy right here. He needs good cover. Man, he's got like no. And she's just gonna have to start punching her ass off. What's this right here? Those who bless you with adrenaline boost your AP by one for two rounds, but inflicts 2 HP per round. Well, that's not bad. Do I have... It doesn't cost me anything. Now I'm gonna punch you, lady. And then you do that twice. There you go. You're gonna love this one. That one is lovely. This one, what does this do? Get closer. Cause this guy. Yeah, I don't see any other guys here. This guy, he can't really see. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna cover this area right here in case this woman tries to move around. Oh, she died. Oh, flanking. Oh, shit. It's funny, there's shielding right there. Let's move right here. Okay, let me see. But this guy's back here too. He is. See, I don't want to put him here. And just he's so fucking slow. Jesus Christ. What is she doing? Is she gonna kill this guy here? That's on two, on three. She can't make it. But the most. No, let's take him out. Go right here. And he's trying to hit through the slats. Oh, it's because he was controlling the guy, that's why. He can run a long ways. And their punches are just like freaking painful. You can't hit him. Line of sight is blocked. But he can put armor on her. Make sure she doesn't take any hits. Let's see if I can get him over here. Well, it's three tiles. One, two, yes, maybe. Right there. It's like one, it's like something per round, I forgot. So she can do a little bit of, she can just kill him, is what I got out there. You have any thrown knives? Oh, there we go, they're right there. So that wasn't too bad. That wasn't too bad at all. I was supposed to act like pirate. The mic is hot and ready for use. Hey, drug heads. Silence. I've taken control of a pathetic ship. If you want to see your precious cargo again, you better be willing to pay. I'm seizing this vessel for the glory of all Trollkind. Viva la revolución! Look at what you got here, a nice little floating tub. Could be a shame if I have to sink it. Voice finally crackles over the radio response. Please stand by for direct communications from the center for this vessel with straight order. Ava Montalvo. Ma'am, you appear to be possession of corporate property. Be advised that a wet work team in your vicinity has been dispatched to your present location. You may minimize casualties by surrendering upon the arrival. End communication. Nice. Shit. Thank you, Percy. I dig it, that wasn't the plan. I figured they would have an interdiction team in the bay the one day we'd have to hijack a ship. Usually they're too busy chasing smugglers down in Pigeon's Point. Ugh. Well, nothing for it. I'll be boring you soon and you can forget what they said about surrendering. It's just a trick to get a clean shot at you. These wet work teams don't fuck around. They'll spray anything that moves. So, change your plans. We'll be sealing this fine vessel after all. Specifically, there's a nice submersible that will make a killer getaway vehicle. Let's get cracking. Wow, this thing just does not end. This submarine. I get a feeling I'm gonna have to like fight my way to into the submarine. Yeah, I knew it. It's never ever easy. You can get there. How is she anyways? Not bad. She needs to take cover though. Need to cover where she can be most useful. I need to get over there. This is the only way to do it. He can move long distances. What happened to all the freaking... There's a bunch of cover over here before. Now there's not. Stuff is solid right here. I can't quite see how this would go down right here. Too much smog and crap. Okay, so that's solid right here. And that's one, right? So they try to flank us. They're gonna be in deep shit. Let's see. What can he do in two moves? Not much, apparently. You can give us some cover, I guess. That's the best thing you can do. I don't know if they can do it now, though. Okay, where is she going? I'd like to get right there if I could. Percy's on the team, huh? But hold on, what is she? She's a rigger, right? Hey, she's a rigger. So where is her rig? Here they are. Here's a shotgun, but that's for like for close encounters. S2. I want to get it. Let's get it right here. And then let's control the drone. Can I control the drone now? How much movement does it have? Not much in the way of movement. Let's see if he can be another target. Ouch. Send the drone out. I'm gonna see if anything's over here. No, it doesn't seem to be. Let's move. Move down here. Let's move her. Let's move her first. Let's start punching. Need a chance. Let's shoot. There we go. There might be more, so gotta be careful. Ah, there's more. Should have known. Sniper. Sniper right there. God damn it. Oh, assault rifle. Are they just gonna escape? Is that what we're gonna do? Can everybody escape? She's the last one, right? Is she escape? No, they can't escape. That is weird. Oh man, how are they gonna take cover here? Back here, there's some cover. And there's no shelter behind that cover. He's a medium cover. I mean, how the fuck? Let's think about this for a little bit. Ah, shit! It's probably not quite what you wanted. Happening there. God damn it. This guy's in better place than her. Command the sniper. Oh, fucking A. It's funny how this cover back here. There's like no cover here. side block. Take this guy out. I don't want to hit this guy really hard in the face. This is two. This is one. So let's kill these guys. Dead. Nice. Okay, so that worked out. That wasn't too bad. This is I'm hoping this is the last fight I have to do tonight because I'm. I gotta get some sleep. I wanted to go somewhere I wasn't. Like I wasn't flanked. And let's just throw this guy away. What is your mess? God damn it. To cover. This cover, having cover helps him. Where can I go to, let me see if I can go here. Well, there's nowhere I can really go here. Let's see. Let's go here. Yep. Grenade? Yeah. Motherfucker. He's knocked out. Let's see if he's got a, he doesn't have a grenade. Nice hit. Back, shoot, yeah, planked, harsh, that is harsh. get her right to where she needs to be. Let's get him in the mix. Let's see if we can flank this guy. See what I can do. Now when riggers can like control two different drones at the same time, that's when it gets kind of cool. Wow, this is like the endless stream. It's hard to see what's going on, there's so much haze. But yeah, let's just punch this guy to death. I think that's all we can really do at this time. Some other weapons. Stay that one. Let's have him first. And then give her some armor. Just so that way she's not all fangulad. And then she can hit him with a mage bolt, I think. 62. Is he better with throwing knives? 90. Oh yeah. I get the feeling this is the last day for this guy right here. Well, maybe not. Should take him out right here though. Good riddance of this gun awful tub. I'll be happy never board a cargo vessel again. Just laying this out there. But given that Shawasi? The way that Shawasi pissed you anyways. If you just go for broke and sink this thing, it might create a nice distraction for your getaway. Then again, it could also make him even more determined to hunt you down. I noticed that they were carrying some undeclared munitions. You could easily rig them up to go off after you exit. Big boom, big glug glug glug, down to go. I should have wanted the more attention we draw to ourselves, the harder things will be later. Good choice, boss, but move fast. We have a lot of time before the big guns arrive. Leave the boat. Let's just get the fuck out. Game favor. Yeah, I mean, we don't need to freaking be blowing shit up. First, see the skinless from the cargo ship. Jackson to the sub, and you're on your way. Sound of approaching choppers on hydrofoils gradually fades as you make your escape deep beneath the waves. In all the excitement, you didn't have time to thoroughly inspect the interior and soon make an unpleasant discovery. There's a dead body in here. There's more. We're gonna be in the sub. Cause actually, that's kind of nice. I like that. But it is saving, so I'm probably gonna stop here. So I want to thank everybody or nobody who who lurked by today. It was kind of a slow night. You know, thank you, Noodles, for stopping by, man. Percy, nice to be back there. Shiawazi will be busy with the ship for a while. Now we just need to slap her. Bye. Sub violently shudders. Your ears are assaulted with a violent noise, which is surely replaced by an even more ominous silence. What was that? Uh-oh. Well, shit. Looks like the engines were shut down. Damn things were worn out or something. Let's sit down there now. Hopefully we can get them running again with the stuff on the sub. I'm saving it right here. Because, I can't play anymore. I love this game, but I love Shadowrun is a great game. It's a lot of fun, but yeah, it's just late. So yeah, I want to thank you guys again, and just say, you know, I appreciate you. I really do. I really appreciate you coming by and, you know, and just kind of checking out what I've been up to. And I know that I ran two streams today, even stopped and then ran another one, but, you know, that's what I wanted to do. So, hey, what the hell? So we're gonna save it right here and continue this some other time or never continue it again. We never know. It could happen. It could not happen. We don't know. Maybe I play it by myself, then tell you all about it later while I'm playing Neverwinter. I don't know. I'm crazy like that. Let me know if you're interested. If you're down, join my Discord and all that good shit. All right, then I'll take your balls. All right, again, my name is Rick. Like if you like, and sounds so spirited when I say that. Yeah, like if you'd like. Give me a thumbs up and like if you like, and follow me on Twitter, Twitch, or sub on YouTube. I'm going to try to make some changes to the channel overall, all channels everywhere, and see if I can brand this thing a little bit better. But thank you for hearing my voice right now. I'm so tired. Have a good night. Peace.
Yeah.